came out in 1995. It's a pretty awesome game. It has like a million ports to other versions. It has PS1 version, which I'm playing right now, which is also the fastest version. And as GBA version, it even came out on the Game Boy Color. It came out on Atari Jaguar, if you even know what that console is. It came out on Saturn as well. And yeah, each of these versions have like tiny differences. Like for example, in some versions there are certain screens missing. There is some sound differences. Physics differences, like in Atari Jaguar, there is no slippery physics, etc, etc. So yeah.
And don't forget about the cage locations.
Yeah, exactly. The cage locations are like different in most versions. Although for PS3, the digital version, it's exactly the same as PS2 version. Playing the American version, because it's the fastest, like you would think maybe, oh, Japanese? No. Japanese has way longer loads for some reason. Like, I tested it on console and emulator. It has longer loads for some weird reason that nobody knows. But yeah. Playing on fast disk speed as well. Mainly, it is being run on emulator as well. We made it a separate category because it's very hard for Europeans to get the console, because it has to be an NTSC console, or well, a chipped one as well, I guess. But yeah, that's why we made emulator a separate category, because it's faster. It's like 50 seconds faster, roughly. So about the game, you'll see me picking up all the cages on the way, because we actually need to collect all the cages in order to unlock the final level. So you would say, yeah, like, why is this not 100%? Well, we're still trying to beat the game as fast as we can, you know. So
in fact, it's not 100%, because you skip some bosses on the way. I guess that's why we don't call it 100%.
Yeah, but bosses don't really count towards percentage. But yeah, I guess you're right. But yeah, you spoil it already though. Like, we'll be skipping one boss. In PC version, you're actually able to skip two bosses, because on PC version, in Mr. Scops, it actually has an exit sign on the first screen. So you just get all the cages, because they're all on the first screen, and then you just hit the exit sign, and then you can skip a boss. So yeah. But on this version, there is no exit point, so we have to do that boss. The one we can skip here is Mr. Sax. Because, yeah, all the cages are on the first screen and there is an exit sign there. So yeah, this boss, there is some optimizations to it. Basically, after you hit him, he always moves... Oh, he's dead already. Like, see how quick that went. But basically, after every hit, he moves to the middle and the top. So you want to hit him so he has the fastest path to the top left, or the top middle, I mean. And then the last hit, you just want to do it as soon as you can, because he moves straight up if you hit him. So hitting him as high as possible is the best. And then this screen, it's an autoscroller. There is a couple autoscrollers in this game. You would think you can't speed this up, but you actually can. If you hug the right side of the screen, for example, you'll do this level about 5 seconds slower than if you would do the optimizations, which is basically at some points of the screen. Of the level, the screen will start moving faster, so we'll be hugging the right side of the screen to trigger that fastness quicker. And then when the screen starts going faster, like now, we're moving to the left, to make that fast screen as long as possible. And then, yeah, we're moving back to the right, because the screen is gonna go faster again. And that's ends up saving like 5 to 6 seconds, so that's pretty nice, that you can actually speed up an autoscroller. That's pretty cool. Did I miss the cage, by the way? I didn't, right? Do you know? Did I miss the cage on the screen? Dude, like,
I'm not sure.
I'm playing automatic mode right now, so I just hope. Like, sometimes I beat a level and I'm like, wait, did I just play this? Like, what happened?
I remember one time where you forgot one page.
Yeah, on TV. That was actually pretty recent. because I was stalking, I guess. I blame Blackham.
You have 3 cages, so it's okay.
If you missed it, yeah, it would be really bad, but I didn't miss it. I just verified it. We're good. But yeah, sometimes I just play levels and I'm like, wait, did I really just play this? Holy shit.
In fact, it's because, as we say, the cage location is different. So it's easy when you play multiple versions to forget one cage.
Yeah, true. Like if I'm playing PC, which has a lot of different cage locations, I'm like, literally in my head I'm saying, okay, this is PC, this is PC, you're playing PC right now, different cage locations. Talking about PC, this level you actually need to do twice on PC, because there is one cage we cannot reach on PC.
That is very annoying.
Yeah, that is also a reason why this version is faster. One of the reasons.
It's very annoying, by the way, because planting plants is the same key as running, so sometimes you just run and don't plant. So, pretty annoying.
Yeah. No, it doesn't matter, I just do it for fun. I just plant flowers because I'm bored, basically. So yeah, that was another Outer Scroller, because you like them so much, and then this screen is quite optimized if you do it right. Like if you wanna be holding right constantly, it's quite optimized. Also, we're doing this damage boost right here. Basically, we're punching the plum and then we're tapping to the left, so we get damage boost to the right. And then during the iframes, we punch the plum to the right, so it lands in the water, because we need to spawn a cage, which we need to spawn while we're in the water. So that's the quickest way to do that.
In fact, every time you get hit, you push on the opposite way you're looking. So you can push like that.
You missed the one up. Yeah, I did. Nah, lives are useless, at least if you play well. We're also playing on password, by the way. You can choose between memory card and password, but the reason we play on password is because it makes the first load of the game faster. So that's the only reason why we play password, because it's 5 seconds faster of the first load in the game.
In fact, if you play in memory card, can be good if you are
starting
playing
out
for fun.
Yeah, or being playing
a playthrough is better. Because you don't have to re-enter the password every time you die.
Yeah, also if you first start running this game, you will probably game over, so you might want to play memory card, for that matter. So yeah, on to Mosquito's Nest, which has a skip called Plum Skip 2.0, which we will probably get, like, at least I hope so, because it looks pretty cool.
Probably.
Yeah, I don't know, man, nerves might screw me over here, although I'm not really that nervous at the moment. But yeah, the goal is to just not get, just keep holding right the whole time. That's the goal, pretty much, of this game, so you don't lose too much time. So here, instead of waiting for these piranhas, we're just gonna try and, you know, not make the plum stop, we're just gonna jump over them and make the plum move the whole time. So yeah, Plum Skip 2.0 coming up. Let's see.
I think playing it casually is very, very hard.
Yep, there we go.
It's like impossible to end this game by playing casually.
So yeah, basically what I did there is I punched the plum, I jumped on it, and then just as we hit the ground in the start, I jump again to make the plum bounce again, and then we can actually use the plum to reach that platform, which is normally unable to reach, and you can skip the hunter, because the hunter always shoots at you, and while he's shooting, you cannot hit him. So you would have to wait, and yeah, that's slow, so yeah. Alright, so on this screen there is a lot of camera optimization as well. Hopefully we can get the early cycles here, which looks pretty cool. Okay, seems like we'll get it, yeah. So if we jump on the right places there, we can actually get through this section on the first cycle by jumping late and jumping early, depending on where you are. And then here, I'll actually turn my screen to the left, so that the cycles that are incoming are reset, and we can actually make a cycle that we're not supposed to, like, we normally don't reach. Like here, I will turn to the left, make the camera switch to the right, and then I can make this plum cycle. Like, if we wouldn't do that, we would have to wait for the plum to go back to the right before we would be able to, before we would be able to jump on it. There we go. Alright.
That's it.
That's it. Please. Okay. Sometimes I don't hit this plum twice and that makes me mad. Alright, can we do this trick? We can actually jump through this. Okay, nice. Yeah, that was really good. So yeah, it's diagonal platforms. Like sometimes if you jump from below them, you can actually jump through the ceiling, which saves a bit of time. Like not much, but yeah. But yeah, I heard you liked Outer Scholars, but here is yet another one. That makes the third one in 10 minutes that we're playing right now. Also,
this one
of the last
ones. This you can't go faster than the Outer Scroll. There's no trick about it. You just have to wait till the end of the level.
Alright, so I can't speak right now. What we want to do here is stay at the right side of the screen to make it a bit faster, I guess, to catch the end sign quicker. Also, what I didn't explain yet is these vines. You can actually, if you're too far to the right of the screen and you're jumping off the vines as soon as you can, it actually boosts you to the right a bit. And if you do that while you're at the right side of the screen, you will actually boost to the towards the right side of the screen and you will die because you're too fast for the screen. So what you really not want to do is, yeah, hug the right while you're jumping off of vines.
In fact, Kitsune, we figured that it's another one because his colors are different. On PC versions, it's the same colors, but on the PC version, in the PC version, it's other colors. So we figured it's another one.
Yeah,
another one.
Nobody knows like what it is. Like someone even said it's his father, this one. But yeah, nobody knows for sure. So yeah, optimizations here, where we will move to the left of the screen so he drops the fruit quicker, because he will move towards us and drops it as soon as he is above us. So what we want to do is, yeah, just move to where he will come, basically. And then here we actually jump over him, because it makes the cycles a bit different, and it ends up saving like 2 seconds. So yeah, if I hit him now, he will stay on the screen one more hit. If I actually damaged him earlier, he wouldn't have done that. And he would do a long-ass cycle, and it would lose like 2 seconds, basically. So yeah, now we're moving to the sides again where we'll come. And now we're just trying to hit him so that he moves to the top and the middle the fastest again. And then here, these hits when he's like on the bottom, it's actually not faster to hit them right away. You want to make him move just a little bit to the left, because he moves like diagonally, like not with an angle or anything, just pure diagonal. And then for the last hit, you actually want to hit him as soon as you can, because again, like the first mosquito, after the final hit, he just moves straight up. So it doesn't matter where you hit him in the screen. And yeah, that was almost perfect mosquito nest, I guess. Let's hope we can keep this up. I actually PB'd 2 days ago, believe it or not, while I was doing practice runs for this. So yeah, who knows? Who knows? And
oh,
PB is also world
no
record.
Knows.
Like, I don't want to be like, you know, like that guy, but just saying. Just letting you know. Alright, so this screen, we actually get the power-up to swing off rings now. That is the also a reason why we go here first, is because we need that power-up to go further. And basically, if you swing off rings, you can hold up, and that will preserve your speed. So that's why we call it speed locking. Basically, the speed you have, as soon as you press up, you will actually store. And that works with all the speeds, so...
Yeah, there's a storm skip.
Storm
oh no,
skip.
Cloud skip.
Oh, cloud skip, yeah. Yeah, like if you fist boost there, which is basically like on slippery platforms, you can charge your fists and you will move into the opposite direction a bit faster than normal walk speed. you can actually cross that gap, which you're normally not able to cross. Rayman hoodie, yeah. My sister made me a Rayman hoodie. She's awesome. There is actually one American who makes these hoodies, by the way, if you're interested, but since American has like 2 week shipping and my sister is like good with cloak making, you know, why not? Also here we'll be doing a skip which is called Spike Skip. We use invincibility frames to actually pass here. Fun fact, on the Atari Jaguar version, you can actually just punch through those blue spikes, like, it's really funny. Yes, yes, you can. But here they have a hitbox, so if you punch, you actually punch against those blue spikes. Yeah, Rayman 1 music is amazing.
Yeah.
That's one reason. Yeah, that's one reason why I still play this game. Alright, so let's see if we can do this trick here. No, dang it. Okay. If I jump on the rocket and the platform at the same time, I would be able to hold down, which is crouch, and I would be able to clip through the walls, and that actually looks really cool, but it only saves a second. But yeah, too bad I couldn't show you that off, but what I can show you off is one of the only glitches in the game, which is called the zip, which is also, I think, the oldest skip that has been found. Basically, I'm gonna jump to the left, and I'm just hoping to not screw it up. Please don't screw it up. Okay, thank god. Oh, that was actually really close. Like, you wanna jump at the last moment, a small jump to the left, and then hold down, and then you just, like, zip through the wall. But yeah, I landed, like, really far to the left, so it was pretty damn close. Dang. Okay. So in this screen, there is a cage you're normally not able to get without the necessary power-ups, which is the helicopter ability. But because of the speed locking, we can actually get there really easy. Like here. All you do is swing off the ring and hold up. Profit. You make it easy. And yeah, that is another reason why we do not have to revisit this place. Like, we can get all the cages on the first run.
Before the app thing was discovered, there was also a way to do that. It was frame protect and nearly impossible to get.
Yes, so, yes, indeed. Like, you would have to get like a big tether. Basically, a tether is the... If you hit a ring, like the chain between the ring and your fist is basically what a tether is. And if you get a big tether, which is punching the ring from further away, you would be able to get the speed required, but it would be really hard to get. And then here, again, we're using invincibility frames to pass that section. Again, a fun fact, on Atari Jaguar, there is no spikes there, and you can just jump over the thing and get the cage like that. Pretty damn funny if you ask me. And you can also get back without that abusing on the Atari Jaguar. You can just make that jump because you jump higher. And then here is the killer, which will probably kill me. Okay, no. Which is also not in the PC version. The killer is not there. Oh, well, I should explain you that anti-tune there, we call it the killer. You know, because it kills runs. Anyway, so now that you know that, we'll be moving on some balls for a bit.
Yeah.
Alright, so cage locations in Rayman. Pretty funny.
Everything is going well.
Yeah, yeah, it is. But yeah, as you can see, an end sign right here, but we'll not be taking it because Rayman has weird cage locations. We actually have to jump over the end sign to get the last cage of this level. Hopefully get it the quick way. Nice, got it. Cool. So yeah, you have to time that really well, actually, to get the cage like that. Like, if you time it too late, you will start charging on the ground. If you time it too early, you will not make it. Also, this is still recce pace, just saying. Probably not for long now, but yeah. Also, we'll be using yet again invincibility frames to pass this guy, which saves about 4 seconds or something. It's not too much.
I think it's HDQ.
Yep, you're right. When it got found, yeah. That's true. Just before Spike Vegeta's run, he found it like the day before with some other people there that you could just like get hit there and run through him. Pretty funny.
There's an awesome pass of GBA version done by Goten. Very impressive. Go watch it.
Yeah, they're being they're working on the on this version pass as well, which is looking amazing so far. Just a couple levels to go, and we have the full test run.
They are just ruining the game.
Alright, so this level introduces our first clip, which doesn't work like the other clips we will do. Basically, we'll jump at a specific time and we will be able to clip through the slippery platform here, if we can get it, that is. I mess it up very often. I messed it up in my PB as well. So if we don't mess it up now, we should be like 5 seconds ahead of PB. Alright, please.
They're ready to get it done, but pretty impressive to watch.
I actually got a really high jump out of it. What the fuck? Okay, that was pretty awesome. I don't mind it not having worked out. That was a really awesome jump. But yeah, that clip, I don't know. I fail it very often.
It's very hard to get.
Mm-hmm. And yeah,
oh,
sometimes...
I remember this level on casual being very hard.
Maybe it's why? What'd you say? Maybe
I
it's
said
why?
This level on casual was very hard to get.
Oh yeah, yeah,
first part of it.
Yeah, for sure. Also, we just got the slowest version for that cage. You can get it while not losing any of your momentum, but if you jump too early, you get hit by the notes, which is the version you saw. And if you do it, if you jump too late, you will actually overshoot and you will go all the way to the left. But yeah. Also, here we will spawn a cage and actually do a fake jump to get there. Sadly, I had to do it twice though, but yeah. But yeah, if we would jump on the small platform, we would actually have to wait until it's respawned. So that's why we do that fake jump, basically. Alright, let's take it easy here. We don't want to be falling down. Dying on this level is actually really bad. It screws up a lot because I have 5 HP right now. If you die, you only have 3. And you need to get a P again to have 5 HP. And we don't get a P anymore until we actually need it, so... Not dying here is very much... very good. Alright, let's see. Small little fizz boost here. And then another one here to make this... these small platforms a bit easier. Like, they're a pain casually, to be honest, these small platforms. But if you do that fizz boost, it's pretty easy.
You can see that.
Alright, so this next screen is actually also not in the... Wait, what version was it not in again? I think it was the... Yeah, the Sega Saturn version. This screen is not in there, I think, if I remember correctly. But yeah, the Sega Saturn version has like really long transitions and really long loads because it doesn't have fast disk speed. So yeah, if we do some precise jumps here, like I just did, we can actually move through this section without losing too much speed. And hey, here is the boss we'll skip. So yeah, this is the only time you'll see him. That is why we made a category called Beat Mr. Sax, because, you know, why not? Which is basically just trying to kill him as soon as you can, which is like an 18-minute run. So that's pretty funny. The screen isn't on Saturn? Yeah, I think it wasn't. Like,
oh, I think he was.
It
I
is.
Remember that. I don't know.
Maybe it was on another version though, but I don't know. I don't remember quite, actually. Alright, on to Twyla Gulch, where we'll be using the holding up thing again, which is called speed locking, to remind you to get past this section a bit faster. Also on the second screen here, there is a really cool one, which I hopefully get. And yeah, we'll be skipping all the cages here, because we actually need to get back here. Because we cannot reach this ring here without the running ability and helicopter ability. Although, even if you have these abilities, that jump is still really hard. If you don't know the visual cues on where to jump, that is. So yeah, we'll be skipping all of them, because we don't have the running ability yet, and we will get it in...
A little PC versions, to be easier to do. But it's still very hard to get this ring.
Yeah, on PC version that ring is much lower, you can even make it without running ability. And yeah, this is Mr. Stone, which is a boss in not the next level, but the one after that. And he's like chasing you here, and then he just jumps away, and then you don't see him anymore until you actually find him. But yeah, this...
Mr. Seth does a very powerful damage boost. So we're using it to go faster than intended.
Oh yeah, and sometimes he doesn't want to follow you, like I just did there. Or if you hug the screen too much to the right, you don't get it. Alright, so here is the swag trick. Hopefully we can get it. It looks really cool. But it's okay if we don't. Ah, we didn't. So you can actually do a precise helicopter there to go all the way to this platform I just jumped on, which looks really cool. Also, this hunter is a really, really, like, it's an asshole. Like, if you jump too, if you jump too slow on these clouds, he will always hit you, pretty much. So you need to jump off the cloud as soon as you can to be able to jump over his next attack, or duck under it. But yeah, ducking is slow, so that's why we jump. And then here, that abuse, which I'm not doing optimally, but whatever. I'm actually gonna die here because it's faster than running back to the left. And yeah, another pretty swaggy strat soon.
As you will see, on some levels there is multiple signing sites. We're using this one because it's way faster than the other one.
Yep.
I think in casual you won't find it, it's pretty hard to find, but as with speedrunners.
Exactly, and it looks really cool too.
Yeah.
Alright, if we move... Cool, no, I jumped a bit too early. Oh well, it's fine. Okay. It's missing in Jaguar? Oh, okay, yeah, I was wrong then.
Okay, thanks.
I'm not yeah, I wasn't sure anymore. Dang, giving you wrong info. God damn it. You always use this exit casually? Well, then you were better than us, okay. I had to use the 99 lives cheat to in order to beat the game. I never beat it without it. But yeah, this is a nice little 2-second auto-scroller. For God knows why. Nobody knows.
Yeah,
and it's over.
if the left screen touches you, you die instantly.
Yeah, exactly. And again, if you go too much to the right, it will instant like kill you as well, I guess. Ah, dang, I forgot to kill that hunter to the left. Hopefully he's... Okay, no, never mind, it's no biggie.
Right.
Alright, there is a 1-second skip on this screen, which if you fail it, you lose like 5, but I'm gonna go for it, just to show it off. It's not really that hard, though. I just wanna show it off, really.
Oh, yeah, this one.
Yep. Let's see if we can get it.
Precision.
Nice, we got it. So yeah, that saves like 1 second, and it's totally worth it, as you can see. It also puts you to 1 HP. But it's fine, because there is a P here, which we will get. Then we're gonna spawn a cage. We're gonna take a photo here to set a checkpoint. We're gonna grab the cage, and then we're gonna death abuse again to get back to the photographer. Also, I'm gonna wait here just to be safe. Like, you can jump on this cloud when the spike is going up, but, you know, let's take it safe, this marathon run. Alright, so now we will be put back to the photographer, and we'll be going to the end. And I will jump too early, and that actually is really annoying, because that's... I think I'm just gonna go YOLO. Like, I don't like doing this part without the damage boost. So yeah, let's just go YOLO, boys. Let's do it. 1 HP, this golem is an asshole. He might kill us. Alright, we didn't die. YOLO worked out for us. That's pretty good. Yeah, that golem is an asshole, by the way. He will hit you so easily. But if you do that damage boost I just did, it makes you be able to get to the golem faster, and you can outspeed him easier, so that's why I went for it. Like, even if I did that part slowly, I could have still died, you know? I don't know, that golem is an asshole. Alright, 31-12 entering this, that's not bad at all. Alright, so here we'll be getting the super helicopter power, which we'll be able to, yeah, helicopter forever, pretty much. But we only get it for this screen. And we actually want to get speed, the speed locking here, and it took me ages to set up. Basically, if you helicopter to the right, there is one or two frames, I don't know how many, of a frame where you move the fastest, and on that frame, you want to start holding up so that you preserve the speed there. But yeah, it took me ages to set up, but it's fine. I didn't die. That's the most important thing.
This screen is easier on the PS version, because there is a lot of P on the way. On PC version, you don't have any P on it, so you just have to do it perfectly.
Oh, you should play this on Atari, dude. It's like a wall, like, oh my god. It's so much fun. Not like helicopter physics in Atari Jaguar is, oh my god, it's like literally unplayable. Like, I swear to god, the person that does this screen without taking a hit on Jaguar gets a lollipop for me, dude. I swear to god.
Guys, you know what to do to have a lollipop.
Yeah, like a nice strawberry one, you know, why not?
Oh yeah,
let's go all out. Alright, so this screen is also not an Atari Jaguar, sadly, because it's a really cool screen. The first time you actually entered this, you were like, what the hell are we supposed to do here? And yes, we used the helicopter hair to cut the ropes, because that's cool.
In fact, this level is often on the trailer during the start.
Yeah, so, true, yeah, the demo. Yeah.
So you can before even seeing it in real.
True.
Yeah, how it works.
Maybe that's
but
why
for
they
real,
did.
It's really hard to get it.
Alright, swag cage here. Which
Perfect.
We, like, this is only possible with a slow fist, but because we died earlier, we did that dead abuse, that actually made us lose our fast fist, because if you die, you lose your fist power-ups. So that's actually good that we have to die there, because then we can do this trick here, which looks really cool. Like, we charge our fist and then we drop down, and your fist always comes back to you like a boomerang, so it actually hits the cage on the way back. It looks really cool, and it saves like 2.5 seconds or something, so it's worth it.
Yeah, in fact, in this game there is 3 fist levels. Every time you die, you lose 1 level of it. So, on this speedrun, you will only see the first level, I guess.
Yeah, unless there is... there is some... You mean the speed stages, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. You don't always have stage 1. Sometimes you have 2 or 3, but... It's not really... There is one part, though, where your stage fist is very important. And I'll tell you later why. Because there is a cage we are able to reach because we have a stage 2 fist or more. Like, with a stage 1 fist, you don't make it. And obviously with a slow fist you don't make it either. Alright, I'm gonna take this HP, because it's marathon. Like, you could skip this, because you basically don't take any more damage until you grab the P. Another P, but let's just grab it, it takes like half a second. No, why not? Alright, so almost at Mr. Stone, which is a really cool fight in this version. You'll be able to beat him like a minute and a half or something faster than you would be casually. Pretty cool. Also, if you land on a slippery platform and you do not hold left or right while you land, you do not get the slippery physics, and you can just jump off it normally without having the physics. Alright, seems like we have good lava balls. Alright, perfect. That was good. Like, those lava balls can be really annoying to pass, but we can actually skip the triggers, we can jump over the triggers like we just did, and that makes the lava balls not spawn on those two platforms, so that's pretty cool. Alright, 36, 12, ah, that's pretty good. Alright, so this fight is pretty cool. It actually got optimized a couple months back, where we'll be able to do this fight even quicker, like 2.5 seconds. Basically, after this hit, we can actually jump towards the boulders he throws, get damage boosted up, and that gives us enough height to actually hit the middle thing. And then here, we try to delay it until as late as we can, because if we hit it any earlier, it wouldn't work, like, it wouldn't go all the way to the right or left to hit him. And then, that's what happens. Dang it, that sucks. Oh well. And these hits, you can actually also do it like that. Like, you jump on it midway, and then you jump off of it to get high enough again. Oh yeah.
There's a soft block on this fight. If you punch too early when you skip, you can soft block your boss and kill your run.
Yeah, basically, if he's like in the air and you can hit him whilst he's in the air, you knock him off the screen and then he takes 5 minutes to get back. Like, he comes back, it just takes 5 minutes for him to come back for some reason. Alright, not an optimal fight, but it wasn't bad. Wasn't bad. I'm also not splitting. I'm just forgetting to split.
I assume so.
Okay. There we go. Rayman, Rayman. Alright, so now, 38 minutes into the run, we finally have the running ability. The speedrun can start right here. Oh yes.
Earlier it was a slow run, now it's a speedrun.
Yeah, like, this Rayman noise is actually from Rayman 3 GBA, but I liked it so much. Oh god, I'm actually dead. Dang, I didn't do that damage boost right. Oh, it's fine. But yeah, this new strat of Mr. Scops, or Mr. Stone, made this level pretty risky, because you're always on 1 HP. But yeah, it's no biggie, that didn't lose me too much. So yeah, we'll be revisiting all the levels and getting all the cages we skipped. And then moving on. Because yeah, like I told you before, we need all the cages in order to be, like, unlock the final level. So this is the jump I meant, which is pretty damn hard casually, but if you know where the... Oh god, I took the key, I'm stupid. But if you know where the visual cues are, it's actually not that bad. So yeah, now we will actually get hit by the lava ball unless we do that. So we avoided that too, good. Okay. And yeah, now we will dead abuse again, because we got all the cages, so might as well exit the level through this end post, so we don't actually have to finish the level. You can just exit it. And now we actually go to Gong Heights. Like, 1 year ago, if you would watch a Rayman speedrun, everyone would be moving to Pink Plant Woods right now, but there is a thing called speed storage that got found, And that actually made the revisit route completely different. If you wanna take your attempt on explaining speed storage, by the way, Svendroy.
Oh, yeah, I can try. So, in fact, speed storage is done while when you boost on a ring or a slippery platform. In fact, there is something we call events. Events are all the things that move in the game, like clouds, like plums, like everything like that. And you can keep some speed when you jump from an event to another one, or die just after having keep some speed. So at the end of the Mr. Sex Hulalu, you can keep some speed and then use it on the plum at what's the level?
Mosquito's Nest.
On Mosquito's Nest. I don't know if it's really clear, because it's pretty hard to explain.
It is really hard to explain, it's really hard to understand as well. But yes, getting speed storage, if you get it while it's going to the right, you actually need to activate it to the right as well, otherwise it doesn't work. But yeah, you'll see the speed storage soon enough. I'll note it out when it happens, because if I get the fastest version of setting up the speed storage, you probably won't even notice that I set it up, but I'll tell you when it happens. Alright, so another auto scroller here, by the way. And now we're moving to Mr. Sex, where we'll be setting up the speed storage. Also, the speed storage travels over the world map, which is pretty weird, but it does. It travels through death, you can hang with it, though if you jump towards a wall, it breaks. So yeah, where's the logic? I don't know. Doesn't matter though, because it's really cool. Alright, nice. We get the fast setup here. Love that. If you time your helicopter correct, you will actually hang on that little platform, which is a bit faster.
This and just one more thing about speed storage is that even if hanging doesn't break the storage, doing a running jump breaks the speed storage. So you have to be very cautious when you try to use it.
Yeah, also, we don't want to take any photographer here, by the way, and also that was pretty bad. Oh my god, that actually failed. If you take the photographer here, we will not be able to dead abuse, and we need to, because we need to get all the cages and then die to get back to the end sign. If you take the photographer, you actually have to do Mr. Sax, the boss. So yeah, this level also introduces the other clips. I told you at Allegro Presto there was a clip we could do by just doing a precise jump. Now it's actually a precise input, which is literally frame perfect. Basically, on any diagonal platform that meets or as a horizontal platform, we, on the right timing, we can actually press down, which we did right there. Okay, starting over. Basically, if you press right or left, and the next frame you press down, on the right specific moment, you will clip through any surface that is not thick. Like, anything that is not thick enough is clippable. Also, I just got speed storage, because I went off the slippery platform, and I got faster speed than normal run speed, and that's what you need to have speed storage. So now we will run off in the pit. I still have speed storage right now, and I will actually move to a plum now, and we'll be able to activate the speed storage we just stored by doing a running jump off an event. So yeah, important is to get to that event here, we need to do a standing jump, so we're stopping for a second. And then we're doing a normal walking jump on the plum, and then a running jump off the last frame of that plum, and then we get enough speed to cross the gap, pretty much. Also, there is a really precise clip there as well, but it's pretty hard without a slippery platform to do that. So yeah. it can waste a lot of time if you if you time it bad.
So without the speed storage, it's not possible. Don't try it.
Yeah, you mean the jump I just did to reach the vine? Yeah, that's literally impossible without it. There is one more instance of speed storage, which is in Space Mama's Crater, which is in about 60 minutes from now. 16, not 60. So yeah, one more level for the revisits, and then we'll be moving to Eraser Plains, which is the first level of Picture City, which is also a very hard level to do correctly in a speedrun. There is a softlock hit that can potentially softlock the game, but if you time it right, it won't. The
as
thing
I
is, you need
as
4
I
HP.
Say, Kitsune, as I say, Kitsune, you can't call that 100% because you know you don't kill all the bosses.
Yeah, that hunter is an asshole, by the way. Like, it's very precise to jump over him, but it's pretty hard. Alright, that was the last cage. Time to go to Eraser Plains. But yeah, basically we are collecting speed fists right now, and we have two in a second. I have one right now, as you can see, and the second one, oh, I'll be picking up right there. So now I have a stage 2 fast fist, and we will use this in the next level. The thing is, the cage we have to hit is on the second, oh no, the third screen. So if we die on the first screen, we either have to go back out, because that resets our fist. So we will be doing that abuse in the start. And then we will actually exit the level, go back in, because it resets our fist to how it was when we came in. And then we will try to get to the third screen and get that cage I was on about. Though if we die on the second screen, we cannot do it anymore. So yeah, it's pretty important to not die after re-entering this level. So yeah, I'm taking some damage on purpose here in the start, because we'll have to die pretty soon. So yeah, we get the cage. It's faster to just die. And then we exit the level and re-enter to reset our fist. So now we have the stage 2 fist again. And now we are gonna try to not die, which is a pretty hard level to do so.
Oh yeah, you can say that.
Also, fun fact, the dark blue pencil is the only pencil in that is round. All the other pencils are actually like not round. We almost got the skip here as well. If you're really fast, we can jump on that pencil and then jump right up to spawn the sharpener. And don't have to wait on the first cycle of the pencils, but yeah, it's no biggie though. So yeah. Okay, that looks good. Just need to get back now.
In fact, yeah, like, everything is hard on this game.
Oh god, yeah, the Saturn version. Oh my god, this level on the Saturn version. Like, you see how many pencils there were in the ink, right? On the Saturn version, there's like half of the pencils. Like, you know, why not? Why not? It makes it really, really... It's like the hardest screen in Rayman 1. Also, this fairy just does not want to spawn sometimes. Look at how high I had to jump to spawn it. Ridiculous. I don't know. His hitbox is weird sometimes. So yeah, on the next screen we'll be trying to get that cage. I say trying because it's not 100% chance we'll get the cage. It's 50%. And why is that, you ask? It's because you can only reach it if you punch on an odd frame. And because we are not TOSBots, we don't know when we'll punch on an odd frame. So, and since odd frames happen exactly the same times as even frames, that makes it 50% chance. So yeah, let's just cross our fingers and hope for the best. The worst I've done here is like 6th try or something, so I got screwed over pretty bad. One. Okay, second try, that's fine. So yeah, it's pretty weird how it works. So yeah, all this trouble to not die just to get that cage, and it skips like 10 to 15 seconds in total, so it's nothing that major, but you know, we take all that we can get. And yeah, take a look at my HP right now. I just used one, and I'll use another one right here. And if I don't fuck it up, okay, nice. We actually turn to the left so we get damage boost to the right to make that section a lot easier. Also, that was perfectly timed. Timing that is pretty hard, but we did it, so that's good. And now we'll be moving back, because we need to be small Rayman to actually beat this level. And also, that is the last damage boost I am taking, unless I get hit on accident. But we're gonna try to not to, because we need to... We can speed up the next boss fight by getting hit. And ideally, we do 3 extra hits, which all require a damage boost. And as you can see, we have 4 HP right now. So if we want to do all of them, we cannot take any hit anymore from now on. And yeah, not getting ones loses like 8 seconds. But... Okay, that was close. That was close. That spiky ball almost sniped me, but we're good. So we have 4 HP, which means we are able to do the soft lock hit. So yeah, if I time it wrong, the game soft locks, and I have no way of continuing the run. Like, I didn't prepare any backups files either, but I'm pretty confident in myself, you know? Like, why not? It saves 8 seconds, you know? 8 seconds is a big deal, why not? But yeah, if you time it well... Yeah, if you time it well, you don't really fail it often, though. Also, these bumps are one of the only RNG points in the game. Like, he throws them at random positions. Sometimes he throws them all the way to the right, which is the best. And sometimes he screws us over, like he did now. Throws us, like, all the way to the left. So yeah. On these next 2 hits, she will throw up the knives at the top of the screen, and normally I'm not able to hit her. But, because we use... the damage boosts, it pushes up high enough, and we're actually able to get another hit off. And again on this one. So yeah, what causes it to soft lock? Basically, if we do that hit on the final hit, you actually kill her faster than the game, you know, wants you. And if you hit her too quickly, then it will soft lock the game and it will just play the victory sound forever. So that's why you need to make sure to have all the knives moving before you hit her. So I'm gonna wait until the knives drop down, and just after the last one starts moving, I'm gonna hit her. Like right there. And we got it.
Yay!
So yeah, if we hit her faster there, and the knife was still up spinning, and not moving, we would softlock the game and we would be stuck in that forever.
You did that very well.
I know, right? Alright, so... we have 1 HP, which makes this part pretty awesome as well, because we'll be doing a dead abuse here and we can instantly kill ourselves on this pencil here, because it's faster than not dead abusing. And then here we can do this unintended jump to get up this platform. Though if you move a bit too far to the right, you will hit the end sign and you will lose some time. But we didn't do it, so that's good. Okay, we got over this hunter, that's good. Alright.
Once again, you fucked up the speed. But it's okay.
Alright, we didn't fail the hit there. Thank God. Like, if you time it just a bit wrong, you will hit the pencil and not the ring, and you will fall down. And you will lose 30 seconds for free. Oh, no! Oh, oh! Okay. 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 Focus, focus. We're still alive. I need to wait until the cycles are lined up now again, though. That sucks, but we didn't die. That's the most important thing. Holy damn, I got scared there for a bit. Also, if we use the speed locking here, we can just pass this section without having to grab anymore. And there is a P here that we grab anyway, so... Alright, so coming up, it's Pantsless! Yes, you heard it right, Pantsless. Why is it called like that? Because when I found it, I called it Pencilless, and someone understood it as Pantsless. So, that's why it's called Pantsless. Sounds logical, right? Now, what does it do? First of all, we are able to punch ourselves into the wall and pass this. Now, and we actually got it. So, like I said in Mr. Stone Peaks, whenever we helicopter, there is one frame we move the fastest, and if we hold up on that frame, we store that speed. And we have to do it literally on the first time you press X here to hover. And you have to get the speed frame the first try, because otherwise you cannot get the Pantsless. And Pantsless, yeah, is basically going through that section without having to wait. So that's what we did right there. If we couldn't get the speed frame, we wouldn't be able to do that. We would have to wait on some cycles. Saves about 2-3 seconds, I guess. It's nothing major, but it looks cool. Alright, so coming up is the bouncy shits. Dude, who names all these tricks? So yeah. Basically, it's like a lot of bouncy platforms. Like, way too many bouncy platforms. You'll see. And we'll have to go down them. We'll have to go down to get a cage there.
And there's many paths possible. One is very fast.
Yeah.
Others are...
Okay, we got it.
Oh, yeah.
So yeah, what you want to do there is three inputs. Down, right, and hover, and then you can get to that section. If you time any of those inputs wrong, you will not make it, and you will bounce up the whole way, and you'll have to use these little gaps to get down, and it loses a lot of time. So I'm pretty happy we got it. So therefore, they're called the bouncy shits, because they're literally annoying bouncy shitty platforms, I guess. So yeah, and now you would think moving to the right is faster, but it's not. We're actually gonna move to the left and do this section again. Also, it's important to not run off that slippery platform, because that will screw
totally
up the cycles. Alright. And that's the leap of faith, where we just jump and helicopter, and we are able to reach this section quicker. Alright, on to space, mama! Super happy fun times.
Oh yeah.
Also, it sucks because I lost 2 HP already. There is a trick called Stormer Skip coming up in the next screen, and we have to use it that well. Not always, but mostly, you lose one hit every try, and yeah, we are only able to try it twice with current health. At least if we don't get hit anymore on the way there, which is possible. Easier than you think. Also, there is a pretty cool cage here on the first screen as well, if we can get the strength for it. The background is nice. Yeah, it is.
Yeah,
pretty awesome. Dude, just the game design in general is awesome. All these, like, you know, level designs, all these platforms, look pretty cool. Alright, we got it, nice. So yeah, if we do a swing, like a tether, we go up, we hit the spiky ball on the way up, then we hover, and then we helicopter, and then we time our hit fine, and we can actually hit the cage without having to knock off any of the other ones. Alright, now for Stormer Skip, which is possible with a slow fist as well, but it's really hard, so I'm pretty happy we have a fast fist here. Now let's see if we can get it. Alright, first try, nice. So yeah, that skips about 8 seconds. The reason I can actually reach that platform is if we go swing off a ring and we hit that ring again with our fist, we can jump again. And we use that just before we reach that sharpener that's up, so that we just get enough height to reach it. And that second jump also pushes us into a spiky ball, and that damage boost puts us on the sharpener, which is really cool. But yeah, overall, oh, that's pretty nice. So, I told you there is another speed storage here, and it's right here coming up. So we're gonna use this next slippery platform here. We're gonna walk off, because if we run off, we get a speed storage that is too fast. And that makes you screw up this jump a lot. So we're gonna do a normal jump on the sharpener, and then we're gonna jump off the last frame, and then we can reach that cycle on the first try. Also, this jump is unintentional, that I just did.
I don't know if it's unintentional.
It is unintentional.
Oh, I'm not sure, because you can't get the one light up if you don't use that, so...
Really?
I'm not sure. Oh yeah, you can't.
I thought you could. I thought if you just jumped in the spikes, you would be able to get it. Ah, dang, I just got hit. That's really bad. Like, just as the first Viking Mama fight, you can speed up the fight here as well on the next fight by using damages. So yeah. And since we don't get a P anymore, this is actually pretty annoying. But what I'm gonna try and do is get a lot of things. Because if you get 100 things, you get a life, and that puts your HP back to full as well. And I think we should be good. 73. There's a lot of things at the top of the screen here. So let's see if we'll have enough. Probably will have enough. Also, like, there is this trick where you just hold punch and jump. And you just re-grab the ring constantly. Okay, nice. Alright, so we got 100 tanks, and we got full HP again. So that was pretty good. Okay, now first gotta hope that Space Mama doesn't hug us. Basically, if we time our hits 4 times wrong, she will keep moving towards us and actually hit us. So let's hope we don't do that. Okay, that's already pretty bad. She needs to move away. Oh god. Alright, we need to hit her to the right now, otherwise I'm gonna get hit. Okay, I got hit. Screw you, Space Mama. Alright, that's gonna make the final hit a bit risky. So, I don't know. Alright, so the reason why we are able to hit her twice is because, like I just did, we hit her as soon as we can, then we actually move to her other side, and because she actually takes time to turn around, that makes her iframes run out, and we can hit her at the end again. Got found by Chatru. Actually, this year, this trick got found, and it saves 15 to 18 seconds. It's really cool, and we can do it 3 times, and yeah, if you do it 3 times, perfect. You will save about 18 seconds over doing this fight normal. It also makes this fight a bit riskier though, but shouldn't be an issue. But yeah, because we got hit in the start, that makes the final double hit a bit risky. But we're just gonna do it the easy way. So again, we're gonna hit her. And then there is a precise visual cue you wanna lay. And just between her weapon and herself, there is a small spot where you don't get hit, which we try to hit, and we got it twice in a row, so that's good. Alright, so we have 2 HP, which would make the second double hit really risky, or the third one, I mean. So we're just gonna do it the safe way, and the reason we're able to do it the safe way is because on the third hit, she actually fires 2 of those beams. And the game developers didn't think, I guess, because you can hit her twice there as well. Like, just hit her as soon as you can, and then wait until she hits you 2 times with the beam. Right, so we're gonna hit her as soon as she can, and now wait until the beams are gone, and then... Ah, we failed it. Yeah, it's really precise. Didn't get it. It's fine, though. That wastes like 8 seconds. Nothing too major. But yeah, we would have been able to hit her there, where I tried it. Should have died then. Alright, that was Space Mama. On to Crystal Palace, which is a very chokeable level.
In fact, yeah, the musics are not played well on PC version.
But, yep. Well, that's true.
Still alright.
Yeah. Yeah, some music is used like very often on the PC version. Alright, let's see if we can do this trick. No! Shit. Shouldn't have went for it. I didn't get the height I wanted, and I still went for it. It was stupid. Let's see if we can try it again. No. Okay, I'm wasting time here. Oh boy, okay.
Holy
crap. Yeah, let's just do it normal. That's usually what happens in decent runs. Just Crystal Palace ruining it all. Basically.
Oh, it's a shame. This skip is so awesome.
Yeah, it is. But it's pretty precise, and the thing that happened can happen. That sucks. Alright, let's not screw up anymore. Preferably. Alright, so this is a cage we actually missed before. Which we will not miss now. Screw this. Like, I was 18 seconds ahead of my my PB. And then I missed that cage, and I went to the next screen, so rip there. Okay, let's just finish this level, please. Okay, fine. I'm starting to sweat a bit. Oh well. That lost us like, what, 30 seconds? Nothing too major, I guess. Still a decent run, so far. Alright, so it's really hard here to actually do running jumps here and not get hit, but we actually did it. Okay, am I gonna get hit by that lightning? No, I'm not. Okay, good. Alright, 3 HP, that's good, because we'll be doing another skip that is gonna cost us 1 damage per try. Which saves like, what, 3 seconds, but it's worth it. Okay, never mind. I got hit once. I might as well just do it normal. So yeah, if we use that swinging boulder, the swinging spike, we can actually grab that platform to the right of it. But we weren't able to do it. Also, we're jumping to the right here to spawn a cloud. This cloud I'm jumping on right now, we just spawned it by jumping to the right. Which is faster than going on that cloud you see to the right, riding it, spawning in, and then going all the way back. So yeah, it's nice that we can spawn it from there. Alright, last cage, and Ida Joes is approaching. Which is weird, because it starts off with like 40 seconds of not able to do anything. Like, it's pretty weird. Just 40 seconds of waiting, basically.
Yeah,
fun fact, in the Atari Jaguar, yes, in the Atari Jaguar version, those 40 seconds of waiting is not there. Like, you can just instantly enter the next screen. Please? Oh god. Wow, those spawns are really bad. Okay, oh my god, we actually made it. That could have been very bad. Yeah, those...
Oh, yeah.
Those spike spawns were so horrible. Oh my god. I'm glad we didn't die. Although, having 1 HP here sucks. Especially with a slow fist for Ida Joes. Dang it. So yeah, on the Atari Jaguar, there is an end sign on this screen, right here. and you can literally just run right and you go to the next screen. In this version, however, you need to wait 40 seconds for no reason, so that's like the perfect...
Come on.
Drinking break.
Listen, Joe. He's explaining, yeah.
Also, these little cutscenes, you can actually spam X to make them shorter. Alright, we're just gonna do it safe here, because we only need 1 HP. Time to show skills. What skills? Alright, jump far enough to land on... Okay, now we get a life here. Good. And now it's some visual cues to get past this level quick. But yeah, on the Atari Jaguar, this screen is not dark, and that's the only version that doesn't have a dark screen here. On the PC version, there is also a dark screen here, and you even see less, like the light it gives is much smaller.
Yeah, there's not this light effect. It's just normal view and dark everywhere.
Yeah. Okay. Alright, so there is another clip here, which is really hard to do. I'll try it once. Because trying it once doesn't really lose too much time. And it saves like 4 to 5 seconds if we can actually get it. It looks really cool. Also, this jump is like literally impossible without a tether boost. And like I said, a tether boost is just getting a really long chain between you and the ring. And yeah, the music is amazing. Alright, so let's see if we can get that clip. Come on. No. If we timed it correct there, we would be able to clip down. But yeah, trying it more than once is not worth it. Oh, what am I doing? Okay. I wasn't supposed to jump in helicopter there. Okay. We can actually jump over a trigger of some enemies here, which we will do. So if we jump and helicopter right here, we jump over the trigger. Because if we didn't, two annoying enemies spawn, and they're really annoying. They're really annoying to pass. Also, there's a secret life here that I don't know how anyone ever found this, but whoever thinks about jumping over the spike, I don't know. This life is also not in the Atari Jaguar version, by the way. Like, that's the only version that doesn't have that life, weirdly enough. I guess it was because Atari Jaguar came out first, and then after that they put it in, I don't know. That makes the logical explanation to me. The most logical one, I mean. Time for some auto-scrollers. And we can actually do this part a bit easier like this. So we don't have to bother with punching those. Oh! Dang. I forgot I had a slow fist and I didn't reach the swinging spiky ball. God damn it. Alright, let's do this again. Alright, intended way it is.
Oh, you can crawl under this.
Yeah, the hitbox is a bit fucked.
It just always jump on it.
Yeah, I did that in the start as well, and then I saw someone crawling around and I was like, what? You can do that? What? Woo, okay. I thought I was gonna land on the platform again for a second there. Dang. Okay. Alright, time for the final screen, which is also probably the hardest screen of this level. Which, when I first started running, I always died here like 5 times. And also, the fish is probably famous to you, or for killing a lot of your attempts here. But just because of that, I will kill him for you. I kill him every time. I will kill him every time, just because he was such an asshole. Oh god, okay. Yeah, if you don't time your jump correctly there, you actually don't make it. God damn it,
yes,
I need to
stop screwing up. Very easy to screw up.
Yeah, as you can see, I still die on this screen. Okay, let's jump later now and we'll get it. Okay, that's gonna be it. Oh, good. So if we're fast, we can actually make this in the first cycle. And this is the fish I was on about. Let's kill him. Always. This is a bastard. Like, probably a lot of people didn't even know you could kill the fish.
You can, actually.
Yeah, you can. Making the same mistakes as me, I know, man. It's nerves, I guess. Not really, just an excuse. Alright, time for Mr. Sculpts. In the PC version, you can skip this guy because there's an end sign here, but... we will have to do it.
Oh yeah, there's no exit.
Yep. Fun fact, on the GBA version, which has the same locations as PC, there is an exit sign, but if you get all the cages and you exit, you cannot unlock the final level for some reason. Which on the PC version you can. So, what the hell?
Yeah, that's why after the screen I don't know what happened. I never do the PS version, so...
yeah.
I'm gonna discover what happened.
Alright, so you're a pretty cool damage boost. Oh god. Yeah, look out how cool that was. Oh my god.
Oh.
That was the coolest damage boost I've ever done, to be honest. Okay. Yeah, I'm screwing up badly here. At least the start of the run was good, you know. At least we have that going for us. Alright, normally I die on the red platforms here, not here. Alright, so no cool damage boost strat, whatever. So cool, yeah. I know, it was amazing.
10-10 damage boost, yeah.
Woo!
Okay,
what am I doing? I'm playing a Let's Play right now. Okay. These red platforms, oh my god, they are annoying. Basically, the cycle you get is always different, basically. And it's a pain to actually jump on them. Okay, thank god for that. 118 entering, oh god, okay. I lost like a few minutes in the last levels. Alright, so this guy, if he nicks off the right platform, he's an asshole. Of course, every time. The reason for that is, if he doesn't knock off the right platform, we can actually jump into him and respawn this platform to the left. But because it's the last platform he will knock off, we cannot do that. So yeah, we have to do it also an unintended way, but it's pretty risky to do it like this. Basically, if you hit him when he's on the edge, he actually moves to the right faster for some reason. Like, you don't even do damage or anything, he just moves to the right for some weird reason.
As I said, I don't know this guy.
Yeah, you're like, what the hell was happening?
Oh man, there was levels after that. Oh, holy crap, didn't know that.
But yeah, you can skip this in the PC version, and PC also has faster loads, and then you would think, well, this version is faster, right? Nah, no, because of the cage locations. There is really annoying cage locations on PC version that take quite a bit to get, quite some big backtracks.
Oh yeah, you can say that.
Hitting like that was intended? Could be, but I don't know. I can't say. It doesn't look intended to me. Because there is a thing on the edge where you normally have to, you know, grab the edge. Alright, so the final level takes about 4 minutes, so... should but at least get a sub-1 in 26.
When you try this guy casually, you don't know what to do, because you can't attack him directly. You have to wait, wait.
Yeah, you can redirect his attacks. Okay, I actually got hit 3 times there, that was bad, but thank god we had 5 HP. Okay. Again, spamming X to make this cutscene a bit faster. And then moving on to the final level, which starts off with Rayman on top of a frying pan.
Oh, and PC that got captured just now. On PC version, it's right after Space Mana.
Yeah.
It's later.
Well, it says that here as well after Space Mama, I think. Okay, let's hopefully not screw over or screw up this. Okay, we won't. If we jump here and then here, we'll make it. Because this yellow stuff, it instantly kills you. That's a bastard.
It's like water.
Yeah. Also, everything is like made out of food. It's pretty cool. Alright, we're gonna grab this life here. Because we'll be doing a trick called Clown Skip, and we need to use HP for every attempt. So yeah, we're gonna get some safety HP.
Always good to have some safety HP.
Yeah. All right. So this is Dark Rayman, by the way. He does exactly the same movement as you. So if you're slow, he will catch up to you, and he will instantly kill you. Okay.
This jump is frame perfect, I guess, because sometimes you succeed it, and sometimes you can't.
Yeah, the reason for that...
it depends on the high of the cloud. So, yeah. Sometimes you can, sometimes you can't.
As you can see, the clouds move up, like, a few pixels, and then move down again, and if you jump while they're on their highest spot, you won't make that jump. So, but that was not the problem. I just failed because I thought I was already on the final cloud. And on this screen, left is right and right is left. So right now I'm holding left, and now I'm gonna hold right. Also, what the hell am I doing? Okay, let's just get it, please. Okay, that's Clown Skip. Saves about 15 seconds, and that's exactly why we got the extra HP, as you can see. I took 3 health to get it, although I didn't do the right jump on the first time, but yeah, it's fine. Alright, getting to the final boss pretty soonish, and that takes about 2 minutes, a little under 2 minutes.
Yeah, I'm standing by on time.
Yep.
No, you can only run.
Yeah, time is in like 2 minutes from now, roughly. So we should get the sub 126 that I wanted. That was like the goal, to at least get sub 26. Yeah, should be easy to get it. Okay, so this fight is actually the hardest boss fight in the game in a speedrun setting. Because you can optimize it so well. At least in the start you can't, but on the second phase you can actually do multi hits on him, and every cycle you are technically able to hit him 4 times, and he has 8 HP, so if you hit him 4 times each cycle you can 2 cycle him, but it's really hard to do 4 hits in a row. And it's even pretty hard to do 3 hits in a row, so that can use you a lot of time.
Most of the runners do it in 3.
Yeah.
3 cycles. I've never seen the 2 cycles.
Yeah, 2 cycle in a run has never happened before. At least not in a world record run. I think Furchter did it once in a run.
Oh,
I've only
impressive.
Done it in practice. Alright, so... I'm not even gonna try it though, because it's like some special shit you have to do. I'll be happy enough to just get two hits, because sometimes they just don't connect, it seems like. Like you see, sometimes it just doesn't get hit. Oh, that was a four cycle. So yeah, these sisters, you can spam, stunlock them if you just keep hitting the same one. And then this one, if you hit him and you hit him again exactly 1 second after, you can do multiple hits. So if you're a Tass, you could finish this by doing 8 hits in a row. And hopefully we'll at least get one double hit, because it's... Okay, there we go. Frame perfect timing there. Alright, so get ready on time. And... time.
Time.
That's it.
It's like a 125.19.
Nice.
You almost popped the 125.
Yep. Not bad. Pretty happy with this. Alright, so you finish this game, and then they say you save the world, and then awesome, 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 and then it goes to the credits. That's about it. And then after the credits, it just goes back to the main menu. So yeah, quite the ending. So yeah, thank you guys for watching.
Thank you guys.
Hope you enjoyed it, and good luck to David for his Kirby run later. Thank you.
Yeah, sick stuff, dude.
See ya, guys.